countdown to liftoff. We are now just 8 hours and 32 minutes away from today's scheduled historic launch from Kennedy Space Center. Weather could be an issue as you look live right now at the launch pad on the right. Good morning, everyone. This is something that hasn't happened in almost a decade, but a new chapter in history may be written today with the first crewed launch from U.S. soil since 2011.
Anticipation is building. We're doing more than keeping our fingers crossed. We've got our toes crossed, too, over here. Storms, we know, could force NASA to delay today's launch. There are a lot of things that have to come into play here. And we're going to check with Richard on the launch forecast in just a few minutes because we're looking at the seas, too. But first, news for Jack's anchor, Bruce Hamilton, in those cloudy skies right now, joins us live from the Space Coast with our Launch America coverage. So, Bruce, as we've been saying all day, I mean, just to be here today, it's historic. Whether or not this launch happens today, we know it will happen at some point.
It will happen at some point. There are contingency plans to fly on Saturday and Sunday, but this is Florida, and afternoon showers and thunderstorms are always a possibility this time of year. I just checked the afternoon forecast, 90% chance of showers and thunderstorms, and it all depends, you know, where they are in and around Launch Pad 39. And the Air Force is going to deliver its next forecast about 12:30 this afternoon. We'll see what they had to say. They can scrub the launch with just 45 seconds left on the clock. Historic in many senses of the word today. First time they're going to launch U.S. astronauts on U.S. soil. You've heard it in 9 years since the shuttle went flying Atlantis 9 years ago. First time public-private partnership, NASA, SpaceX. First time during a pandemic. Now, the two astronauts who are on board, they are very familiar with the risks, and make no doubt about it, there are risks with this flight. These two guys joined the astronaut corps at the same time since 2000. They are buddies. Heard some interviews with them. They've got each other's backs. They kind of read each other's minds. In fact, Bob Behnken said, when it comes to Doug Hurley, I can ask him a question and he kind of knows the answer before I even ask it. That's how symbiotic their relationship is. They go way back. They are both training pilots, and this is a training mission. They call it Demo 2. And basically what they're doing is training for the future, because ultimately they want to use these missions to get to the moon, Mars, and beyond. So let's find out more about these astronauts and what they're all about.
Behnken was an experienced Air Force test pilot when he was first selected by NASA to join the astronaut corps in 2000. He last visited space on a shuttle mission in 2010, spent 700 hours in space, with 37 of those taken up by spacewalks. In the time since, Behnken became a dad. And on May 12th, he tweeted he had to get his son's approval before this launch.
After, you know, having a child and being a father, there is a different level of preparation, both to share the mission with my son, which is something I'm super excited to have the opportunity to do. Of course, he's only seen pictures and video from before he was born from my previous missions. But certainly there is risk associated with a mission like this as we go forward. But I do want him to know that it's a mission that I feel strongly about. It's going forward in a way that I think is important for us as humans, but as Americans as well. And I want him to be proud of his father as we kind of go forward with the mission.
His partner on this mission is Doug Hurley, a retired Marine who also joined the astronaut corps in the same year, 2000. A veteran of two space missions, he last flew in 2011 on NASA's final shuttle mission. Rather poetic. One of the last U.S. astronauts to launch from U.S. soil, and now one of the first in 9 years.
It's kind of neat because, for me, because, you know, it has been such a long road, and it's kind of been a journey, a personal journey, right along with NASA's journey to kind of transition from, you know, the space shuttle era to this next era of spaceflight for NASA and the United States, for that matter. And so I just, you know, it's hard to believe in some ways, you know, you when somebody says it, you're like, well, that can't possibly be me, but it looks like it's going to be. So you know, we just try to, you know, we take it on board just like anything else, and, you know, probably do a lot more thinking about it when we get back than now. I think, you know, we're certainly focused on our jobs, you know, to make this a very successful mission.
This is the first time Behnken and Hurley flew together. And like his counterpart, Doug Hurley's son had a say about dad flying into space. In fact, his son gave his okay by having dad share this drawing of Crew Dragon in late April. NASA has yet to decide how long the two will remain on board the International Space Station, They'll perform some tests on Crew Dragon and do some tests as well as research with the ISS crew. And when the decision's made to come back to Earth, they'll splash down in the Atlantic, where they'll be greeted by a SpaceX recovery vessel.